All right, Michael, so that covers decision trees.
Excellent.
So since you're the one who's listening, you get to tell me what we've learned today.
Well, we learned about the decision tree representation. We learned the top-down algorithm for inducing a decision tree, and we call that ID3.
All right, so we got a representation, we got a top-down learning algorithm, ID3.
We learned about the expressiveness and the bias.
Right. So those are two separate things. We learned about the sort of expressiveness, and we learned about the bias of ID3.
And we gave one. So is this specific to ID3? We looked at one specific way of deciding on splits, which was to do this maximum information gain.
Right. So we talked about in general what are good attributes or what are best attributes. So information gain is one way of doing it, as one example. And by the way, this notion of best attributes is something we'll end up returning to, sometimes explicitly and sometimes implicitly, throughout the entire course.
And lastly, I feel like we talked about the problems with overfitting and how in the decision tree context, you can prune back the tree to avoid overfitting.
Overfitting's an issue. Overfitting is always an issue. And we came up with a couple of strategies for dealing with overfitting in the context of decision trees. Okay. So we've learned everything there is to know about decision trees. There's nothing else to know.
Somehow I find that hard to believe.
Yeah, there's a lot there. And the students will get a chance to learn even more as they do the assignments.
Cool.
Excellent. All right, Michael, thank you.
Sure. Look forward to the next chat.